boom. You know what? I just go in, I hit buy, I hit sell. All right. I don't have to know what I'm doing. Okay. It's easy to blow my money in YOLO. To make trades and buy. Okay. Bear gang till I die. Ho, swooped up the
homies and we about to start a side show. Robinhood IPO. Disclaimer. Disclaimer. Not telling you to buy. Okay.
All right, I'm not telling you to buy this, okay? Are we understanding there? Okay, what are the downsides? Okay, what are the downsides to this IPO? Number one, the free trades. They used to corner the market on quote-unquote commission-free trades, okay? Free trades, okay? That was one of the biggest things that had Robinhood going for it, okay? They don't corner that market anymore. All the other brokerages are doing that on shares, okay? Not on options, but even with options, it's like 65 cents. So it's almost nothing. So that's not good. Two, reliability, okay? A lot of concerns of reliability. They've had outages. They've had downs. They've had some of those issues. Three, bad press, okay? They're getting sued all the time. They've been fined by the SEC for allowing loopholes to have unlimited money glitches and people finding ways around them. They've also had bad press with people go over-leveraging and going all in, and then one kid unfortunately committed suicide. There's some downsides here. Okay, there's some downsides. All right? I'm not against that, okay? And these are going to come back to hurt them in the long term. But upsides, okay? Number one, their UI. Their user interface is fucking perfect, okay? It's perfect for every... It's literally like, I don't know, candy cigarettes, right? Like, the kids want to... No, that's probably a good idea. It's like CSGO skin gambling, right? So adults all go to the casinos, but if you're a kid, you know, you want to see flashy lights and you want to see fun and cool and something, blah, blah, blah. You know what? How do we get these kids to blow all their money? Well, we can't go to casino. It's too big. It's too vast. They're not old enough, but we can. So its user interface is amazing for beginners. Okay. You can literally look at it and not be intimidated. You don't have to worry about charts and bars and volume and green line go up, red line go down. And it's great for, you know, everything. It's perfect for beginners, especially not just kids, anybody. Beginners, it's perfect. Okay. Webull is kind of coming along with them, and there's a few others there, but compared to something like Thinkorswim, Robinhood is a godsend. Okay. Number two, ease of use. Okay. Just like the user interface, boom. You know, I just go in, I hit buy, I hit sell. All right. I don't have to know what I'm doing. Okay. It's easy to blow my money in YOLO. To make trades and buy. Okay. It's great. Number three, the phone app. Okay. Not only did they have the easiest to traverse phone app of anybody else, but it goes back to the first two. Everything that they have on the desktop is on the phone. Boom. I pick out my phone. I'm sitting here scrolling Reddit and I saw some dude talk about, baby powder and how his kid got a rash from Johnson & Johnson baby powder. Fuck it. I'm going to whip out my phone and short Johnson & Johnson. I mean, you know, it's that easy. You know what I mean? Oh, my buddy, you know, just got a bad batch of Oxycontin from his dealer and he died. You know, who makes Oxycontin? Johnson & Johnson. I'm shorting Johnson. You know what I'm saying? Like, you can easily just bust out a trade regardless of it. Number four, Zoomers. Okay? That's their bread and butter. Okay? And until Webull takes more of that market share, okay, Robinhood has the kids. Okay? And they've got all these people that are brand new to it that's getting hyped up on trading because they've got the stimulus, they've got the unemployment checks, and they've been using it, and their friends are telling their friends, and they're getting them to download the code and get a free stock and everything like that. Robinhood's doing a lot of money in advertising right now. They have a ton of upsides. So my prediction, depending on when they IPO, is probably doing one of those on the first few days or first week. I mean, it just has a ton of potential. There's several other factors, but these are the main factors I'm looking at, okay? Their user base is massive, okay? They have the users, okay? They have the users, especially the Zoomers and Millennials, but they have the users, okay? It's become a video game, a gambling video game, an online casino for a lot of people. And while that wrecks the kids and the wrecks the people, it's good for the business side. And they have the hidden weapon. Robinhood has the ace in the hole. This is Robinhood's thing. For two reasons, Robinhood IPO loves Wall Street Bets. Number one, because Wall Street Bets convinces all these kids to YOLO all their money into options on Photoshopped gains. But number two, who do you think is going to pump the shit out of this stock day one? They are going to hype this shit up for 2 weeks ahead of time. The big boys, the real big boys in Wall Street Bets are going to buy pre-IPO, then go on and spam every post in the world of why this IPO is going to go up 100% in a day. And when it does IPO, get all those kids to buy in, pump that stock up, and then they're going to sell. Don't sue me. I'm just saying that's potential. Okay.